Hello, my name is Dr. Chris Malaisrie. I'm a cardiac surgeon at Northwestern Medicine at the Bloom Cardiovascular Institute. Our patient today has a large aneurysm of the aorta. We will be replacing the aortic aneurysm, and in addition, we'll have to repair the aortic valve. Please join me today in the operating room as we perform open heart surgery. Aortic aneurysms can be life-threatening if left untreated. John Ritter had an aortic aneurysm, which ultimately ended up being a life-threatening condition for him. So the purpose of this operation is to repair the aneurysm before it turns into a catastrophe. So we've made skin incision. We've divided the breastbone, that's called the sternotomy. And we've opened up the wrapping around the heart called the pericardium. And here you can see a large aortic aneurysm measuring more than 5 centimeters. So this tube of aorta is too big, and this is what we mean by an aortic aneurysm.
Right now we are on pump, meaning that the heart-lung machine is doing the job of the heart and the lungs.
So the heart is completely still. This will allow us to open up the chambers of the heart and operate on the diseased valves within. Okay, cold pour, please.
That's gonna help us cool the heart all around it, which protects the heart during the surgery while the heart is stopped. This patient has an arrhythmia called atrial fibrillation, which happens when there's abnormal electrical circuits inside the heart. This causes irregular heartbeats and a higher risk of a stroke. Part of our surgery is called the MACE procedure. What we do is we create scar tissue in the heart that will interrupt these abnormal circuits of electricity to stop the atrial fibrillation.
We're using a cryoprobe to create scar lesions in the non-pumping chambers of the heart. And this probe gets pretty cold. It gets down to minus 150 degrees Celsius.
All right, we got a lot of work to do here.
We're gonna replace the aortic aneurysm with this Dacron graft. And this Dacron graft is woven polyester, and it's constructed as a tube. So instead of the patient having a large aortic aneurysm as a tube, they'll have this Dacron graft tube. The heart is a very efficient pump. It'll pump approximately 1 million barrels of blood. And in order for the heart to work efficiently, all the valves have to work in a correct fashion. For this particular patient, the valve closing is inefficient, which allows the blood to leak backwards in the heart, and this will eventually lead to heart failure if left untreated.
We have to operate on a part of the aorta that we cannot reach when there's blood going through the aorta. To do this, we have to stop the bypass machine, which we can only achieve by emptying the patient of all his blood. To be able to do this, we have to bring the patient's temperature down and give a good dose of anesthesia. It causes the brain metabolism to drop down to minimum. That's why the faster we do this portion is gonna be the best.
Mm-hmm. So I'm looking at the aortic valve here. You see 3 leaflets. As expected, they're overstretched from the aortic aneurysm. So what we're gonna have to do is to reduce the length of the leaflets. Next step is to put the coronary arteries back on the Dacron graft and then sew the 2 aortic grafts together. So I'd say next hour is gonna be a lot of sewing to get this back together. Corey, we've completed the repair. So we're giving a solution to help wake the heart up before we release the aortic cross clamp. Once we release the aortic cross clamp, a lot of times the heart isn't in a regular rhythm, so we have to shock the heart. So it's a lot like the CPR you see on the TVs. Anatomically, we thought that the repair was a good one, but we're never really sure until we see how the valve functions in a physiologic state. Dr. Aaron Reynolds here, who's an expert in transesophageal echocardiography, sees that the valve works normally and all the aortic leaking is completely resolved. So we're very happy with how the valve repair turned out. We're off heart-lung machine now, and you can see that the heart is functioning normally. We've fixed the aortic valve, we've taken care of his atrial fibrillation, and we're about ready to close up the chest. Being a cardiac surgeon is a tremendous responsibility, but it is extremely gratifying. We love seeing our patients recover after surgery, and eventually return back to normal life with a well-functioning heart.
The procedure went great today. We'll be recovering the patient in the intensive care unit overnight. We'll continue to monitor him for the next 5 days, and I think he'll make a great recovery. Thank you for joining me inside the operating room.